Hello friends, this is Dr. Hemchand Kothari from ESS Academy. I welcome you all in my YouTube channel. Friends, in this lecture we are going to discuss a new topic, that is correlation. Okay, though the theoretical part of the correlation I have discussed in the previous video that is uploaded there in my YouTube channel. You can just visit it and find it. And today we are going to discuss a numerical portion. And the first video, this is covering the first method, that is Karl-Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Okay, so let's start. We have a question here, that is we are given age of husband and age of wife. Okay, so we have to find out correlation between the age of husband and wife. So this is only an example here. This is very very obvious. There will be a positive correlation between the age of two person. Okay, as one person will grow, definitely the other person will also grow. Okay, so even after, this is a example here or a question here, we have to understand how this correlation works and how the correlation value under Karl-Pearson's coefficient is calculated. So age of husband is 20, 23, 27, 31, 35, 38, 40 and 42. And second column, age of wife, it is 18, 20, 24, then 30, 32, 34, then 36 and 38. So these are the figures as age of husbands and wife. So we have to calculate Karl-Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Okay, so for getting the answer or the solution of this problem, we first need mean value. Okay, the first step that you need to do is to calculate mean for both the series, for both the values. So let us assume this age of husband as X and age of wife as Y. Okay, the first step is this one. Then get the total of these X's as well Y's. So sigma X and sigma Y. So sigma X gives you 256. It is 256 and the sigma y gives you 232. This is sigma x, summation of all x values, summation of all y values gives you 256 and 232 respectively. Now from x series you calculate x bar becomes sigma x upon n. Okay, and y bar becomes sigma y upon n. Okay, so this gives you value equal to 256 by, we have 8n, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, and it gives you answer 32. Okay, so mean of x series is 32. Similarly, mean of y series is 232 by 8 equal to 29. Okay, 29. So these are two means. We first need it. Okay, next we need to calculate deviation from these mean. Okay, this is small x equal to x minus x bar. Okay, so this is our x and this one is our x bar. x bar is 32, first x is 20, so 20 minus 32, that is minus 12. Okay, 20 minus mean value 32. We are taking deviation from actual mean while calculating correlation value by Carl-Pearson's method. Okay, next one is 23 minus 32, this will give you minus 9. Okay, minus 9. So this we follow for all the x's and we will get the values here. These are minus, next one is minus 5, next one is minus 1, next one is 35 minus 32, 3, next one 38 minus 32, 6, then 40 minus 32, 8, 42 minus 32, 10. Okay, so these are the deviation from actual mean in x series. So next we need square of these x values, x square, deviation square. Okay, so 12 into 12, this gives you 144, 9 into 9 gives you 81, 5 into 5 gives you 24, 1, 9, 36, 64 and 100. These are your x square. Okay, next we need small y. Small y is nothing, it is just y minus y bar. Okay, this is y values minus mean of y, this is y bar, mean of y series, right? So first y is 18 minus 29, this gives you minus 11. This is first, I'm just writing here, 18 minus 29 equal to minus 11. Okay, this is minus 11. For next, 20 minus 29, this is minus 9. Okay, and so on. So this will give you minus 5, 30 minus 29, 1, 32 minus 29, 3, 34 minus 29, 5, 36 minus 39, 7, and 38 minus 29, 9. Okay, so the same we apply for y as well. So small y becomes squared, this is y square, deviation of y series, and is squared there. This is 11 into 11, 121, 9 into 9, 81, 25, 1, 9, 25, 49 and 81. Right? So these are the squared value of deviation in y series. Okay? So y squared. Last column we need small x into small y. Deviation of both series. Okay? Deviation of x series into deviation of y series, small x into small y. Okay. So this is minus 12 into minus 11. So minus minus will become plus. This will give you 132. Okay. Minus 9 into minus 9. This will give you plus 81. Minus 5 into minus 5 gives you positive 25. Minus 1 into 1, this will give you minus 1. Next, 3 into 3, 9. 6 into 5, 30. 6 into 5, 30. 8 into 7, 60. Sorry, 56. And 10 into 9, 90. Okay. So, these are the XYs. X multiplied by y or small x multiplied by y, deviation of x series multiplied by deviation of y series, right? Okay, now what we need now, we need a formula. Okay, the formula here becomes correlation equal to sigma xy upon under root sigma x square into sigma y square. Okay, so we have a formula of calculating correlation by Kahn-Pearson method, that is correlation is denoted by small r equal to sigma xy upon under root sigma x square into sigma y square. Okay, so this is the formula of calculating correlation value by Kahn-Pearson's method, right? So we need the summation of xy, summation of x square and summation of y square. So x square, sigma x square becomes 460. This is 460, right? Sigma y square is 392. Sigma y square, we have 392. Summation of all these values gives us 392. And final one, sigma xy, this gives you, sigma xy gives you 422. Summation of xy is 422, right? So now put this value in formula, sigma xy gives you 422 by square root of sigma x square is 460. Into 392, that is 422 by multiplication of these two is, it is 180320. Okay. Then it is 422 by square root of this value is, it is 424.64, right? Square root of 180,320 gives you 424.64, right? Okay. Now divide it and you will get answer 0.99. So 0.99 is your answer. So correlation becomes 0.99. Okay. So this is high degree, almost perfect you can say, high degree positive correlation. So you will write it as high degree positive correlation, right? So then this was the calculation procedure of correlation by Kahn-Pearson's method. Thank you very much for watching this video. Have a nice day ahead. God bless you.